Betts?
Here.
Fox?
Here.
Heck?
Here.
Hetrick? Kaufman?
Here.
Klopp?
Here.
Lidle?
Here.
Palmer?
Here.
Rissbiller?
Here.
Looking for a motion for the acceptance of the minutes?
So moved. Acceptance.
Any comments? Roll call?
Hetrick? Lidle?
Yes.
Rissbiller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Mr. Lidle, if you go over the financial reports, please.
4.0 financial reports, May, 4.1 to 4.13, as listed.
Excellent.
Any comments? Roll call?
Lidle?
Yes.
Rissbiller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Any citizens or students wishing to address the board pertaining to agenda items only? Seeing none, we'll move on to the reports and recommendations of Superintendent Dr. Mesko.
The only thing I have tonight is just to update everybody on the bids. Originally, I got the 21st stuck in my head, but the bids will be open on the 23rd at 1 o'clock here, so this Thursday. And then we would be looking to act on those bids to either accept or reject come the 28th. We would have a special board meeting at that time.
Any new inklings? Any new inklings?
No, we just had the last addendum go out. We had 6 addendums total go out to the contractors. We had a little over 270 questions, so a lot of participation throughout the project. And now we're just preparing for 2 days out. Some concern, I think we've talked about that at the board table very many times. We're all see what's occurring in the market. So let's see what happens in 2 days, and then we're going to have a strong conversation next Tuesday with all of you. Hopefully it'll be a positive discussion.
That's what you're bringing us.
Yes.
And I guess I'd follow up too. The decision, although you're meeting on the 20th, doesn't have to be made on the 20th.
Yeah, maybe I can go through that a little bit. We've been talking about this for, 3 years now. Correct. We will receive bids this Friday. The contractors have 2 days contractually. They can drop their bids if they make a mathematical error. So that's part of the reason that we'll come back to you next Tuesday. It gives them a few days to just vet and make sure that there's no errors. We'll be looking at who all the general or all the contractors are. Pretty much everybody that we're seeing across the board are pretty standard bidders in central Pennsylvania for school construction. So we're not really seeing any anomalies. But if we would, that we would be reviewing it with the solicitor as well in preparation for Tuesday. Correct, we don't have to award on Tuesday, though hopefully if the numbers are where they need to be, you'll be able to. But if you wanted to have more time, contractually you actually have 60 days to award contracts. So you could sit back and think about it. If bids are high, you have the ability to negotiate with the apparent bidders. That's actually something that's locked in legally with the Department of Education. So you have some avenues that you can investigate moving forward. So, and then what we'll be presenting to you on Tuesday, we'll have the results for all the bidders. And then the goal is to have the base bids and then potential alternates, which we've been talking about. So not a lot more information tonight, but if you have any questions for me, I can answer you.
No
only other thing I'd say is we've, to the positive, we've had a lot of interest in the project. So hopefully that, you know, on the back end is a positive thing for us.
All right, items for board action.
So we do not have a meeting now on the 23rd. I'm looking through my calendar.
Right, it's on the 28th.
I do have communication.
Oh, you do?
Alexandria Reinhold sent us a letter thanking us for the opportunity to do work-based learning. So if anybody wants to read it, you can pass it around and you can read it though. You ready?
Yep, go for it.
9.0.1, approve the 2022-2023 junior-senior high school ATSI plan as presented.
Excellent.
Any comments? Roll call.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
9.0.2, I make a motion to approve the special education comprehensive plan as presented at the 05-03 2022 board meeting.
Excellent.
Any comments? Roll call.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
9.0.3, I make a motion to approve the independent contract with Diane Rochester to provide professional services for child accounting and state PIMS reporting.
Excellent. Any comments?
So now this was the person who was retiring, but she's going to let us do this kind of, is this like a short-term basis? Or, I know she's very knowledgeable.
Yeah.
It's just short-term. Yeah. Right.
I believe it's at what her current rate is. So we pay her hourly by her rate, which is 25 or 35 or something.
Any other comments? Roll call.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
9.0.4, I make a motion to approve the special education agreement as presented in executive session for student 301501.
Excellent.
I'm sorry, 510.
Any comments? Roll call.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes. All right, moving on to finance. Mr. Lytle.
9.1.1, I make a motion to approve the adoption of the final budget for the 2022-23 school year with projected expenditures of $38,960,896 and projected revenues of $38,709,160, including a real estate tax millage rate of 25.90, Act 511 per capita tax of 5, School Code Section 679 per capita tax of $5, 0.5% earned income tax, and 0.5% real estate transfer tax.
Excellent.
Any comments? I will add that that is a 0.1/10 of a mil decrease from where we are currently today. For a 6-year streak of decreasing the taxes.
Any other comments?
Roll call.
Klopp?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
9.1.2, I make a motion to approve the adoption of the 2022-23 Homestead and Farmstead Exclusion Resolution.
Thanks, sir.
Any comments? It's a change from last year. It's actually $266.85 is the Homestead Farmstead Exclusion. It's up from $209 last year because the state gave us more money. They gave us $811,000. So we're excluding $10,303 off of everybody's tax assessment for that purpose.
Any other comments?
Roll call.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riss Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
9.1.3, I make a motion to approve the tax resolution to levy taxes for the 2022-2023 school year.
Excellent.
Any comments? Roll call.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riss Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
9.1.4, I make a motion to approve administration to make any necessary journal entries and budget transfers to the financial statements of the school district after June 30th, 2022.
Excellent.
Comments? Roll call.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riss Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes. 9.1.5, I make a motion to approve the commitment of funds for the following categories in accordance with GASB 54 and Board Policy 620.
Excellent.
Special education program, benefits, athletic facility improvements, curriculum.
Excellent.
Any comments?
Roll call.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riss Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
So 9.2 and 9.2.1 we're going to table and move on to policy with Mr. Heck.
Give first reading with the intent to give second reading and final approval on July 19, 2022, the following policies as listed. Next page.
Any comments? Roll call.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riss Miller?
Yes.
And we have one more here. 9.4.2. Approve the deletion of the following policies.
Any comments?
I have a comment about the library material selection and converting to administrative regulation. I think we should keep that as a policy. And I think some of the wording on it needs to be changed. I expressed this to Andy. What is this school library bill of rights? That should be taken off. I'm sorry, but and there's other wording that I think needs to be changed.
Yeah, I agree. I think that the word
we can back that one out and revisit that another time if we're okay with the other four as listed, or we could put the whole thing on hold and bring it all up.
I'm okay with the other ones, it's just that.
Yeah, I'm okay with the others too, but I was reading this library one and I'm concerned as well.
So just so everybody knows, what I did is I took the current 109.1 as the policy is written and pasted it in to make it administrative with some changes that I knew. One of the requirements was that the final selection of materials, like if there was a controversy or something to be removed, would be kicked up to the curriculum committee as a final recommendation to the board. So that was added. But there is a section from our old policy, and I'm assuming that it was recommended at some point by PSBA back in, probably, I think that policy is from 2000. But I'll take a look at it, revisit it, and tweak it, and I'll get it out to everybody.
And you want to, bounce off
the curriculum,
three of us,
the policy,
the curriculum,
yeah.
Because I have some suggestions.
Yep.
You know, I like to get them.
So if we're going to move forward with this motion, we should amend that motion, right?
I move that we amend the motion to withdraw the library material selection from the motion.
Exactly my words.
So we're Bill made a motion to remove the number 109.1 library material selection out of 9.4.2. And Heck seconded.
Thank you.
Any comments? Roll call.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Clough?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riz Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Okay, now I believe we need a motion for 9.4.2 with number 008. Number 112.1, number 115.1, and number 121.1. That's what you did.
I think the amended motion, original motion included all the amended motion said.
Okay, so we don't need another motion.
Okay, got it.
So we're moving on.
Yeah.
Okay. Moving on to curriculum.
9.5.1, I make a motion to approve the agreement with Hamburg Area School District for students to attend Tulpehocken Area School District agricultural program for the 2022-2023 school year as presented.
Take the next one.
And 9.5.2, approve the agreement with Schuylkill Valley Area School District for the same thing.
Heck, sir.
Any comments?
Any numbers yet?
We have two with Hamburg and two with Schuylkill Valley.
And you all look there.
So that one that you had told me just came on. Yeah, so that put us at two and two, right? Yeah. Now maybe you know a third one, I don't know, but that'd be good.
I could work on it. Any other comments? Roll call.
Clough?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick? Lytle?
Yes.
Riz Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
9.5.3, I make a motion to approve the submission to PDE of the flexible instruction day plan as presented.
Excellent. Any comments? Roll call.
Palmer?
No.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riz Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Clough?
Yes. 9.5.4, I make a motion to approve the following textbook as listed below.
Excellent. Any comments? Roll call.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Riz Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Clough?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
9.5.5, I make a motion to approve the student teaching placement affiliation agreement between Tulpehocken Area School District and Alvernia University from June 1st, 2022 to May 31st, 2025 as presented.
Yes. Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
All right, and before we move on to personnel, we are going to have a brief executive session.
For what purpose?
For personnel reasons.
He already did that for stopping.
All right, we're going to come back to order and go into personnel. Mr. Palmer.
9.8.1, I move that we approve the following healthcare personnel for the 22-23 school year as listed there.
One second.
Any comments?
One thing is blatant, that is.
Because it's state set.
Roll call.
Lytle.
Yes.
Chris Miller.
Yes.
Heck.
Yes.
Betts.
Yes.
Kaufman.
Yes.
Klopp.
Yes.
Palmer.
Yes.
Fox.
Yes.
Petrick.
Yes.
9.8.2, I move that we accept the following resignations. Diane Hartruska for the purpose of retirement, effective June 29th, 22. Eleanor Stickler for the purpose of retirement, effective July 29th, 2022. Leslie Schaub, resigning as a school counselor, Penn Burnville, effective 7/17/22. Lisa Geisinger as a part-time learning support paraprofessional at junior senior high school, June 3rd, 2022. Caitlin Harmon as a part-time cafeteria work employee at the end of the 21-22 school year, and Victoria Kramer as an emotional support teacher at the junior-senior high school, effective 6/10/2022.
Second. Any comments?
I'd just like to acknowledge the first two there, Diane and Eleanor, for I don't know how many years, but I know it's a lot of years of service to Tulpehocken, and they will be missed.
And I will invite both of them to the June or to the July meeting, similar like what we did with the others.
Roll call.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Petrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
I move to approve the employment of the following: Crystal Thompson as a school psychologist at a salary of $60,484, effective the beginning of the 22-23 school year.
Excellent. Any comments? Roll call.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Petrick?
Lytle?
Yes.
9.8.4, I move to approve the following professional staff salary adjustments based on credit attainment according to the collective bargaining agreement as listed there.
Any comments? Roll call.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klopp?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Petrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
9.8.5, I move that we approve the support staff compensation plan as presented to the board.
Excellent. Any comments? I would like to mention this. You want to speak to the details
sure.
of that?
The compensation plan that was presented that we will be putting in place is, it calls for all support staff over 5 years.
of service to the district and above will receive 15 cents per year of service added to their base rate. So someone that has, 5 years will get 75 cents. Somebody that has 30 years will get, $4.50 added to their base rate as a thank you for the years of service that they've put in to the district. All the support staff between zero and, or newly hired and 4 years will get 50 cents added to their base rate. And then all starting salaries or starting rates will be increased to 50 cents as well.
And this is over and above the normal
performance-based,
evaluation-based raises.
And the reason it's being done is to keep us more competitive in the labor market and also treat our staff more fairly compared to the rest of the labor market. We realize what's happening now.
Roll call.
Coughlin.
Yes.
Clough.
Yes.
Palmer.
Yes.
Fox.
Yes.
Hetrick. Lytle.
Yes.
Russ Miller.
Yes.
Heck.
Yes.
Betts.
Yes.
9.8.6, I move that we approve the amended administrative salaries for the 2023 school year, based on the Act 93 agreement and the written contract of the superintendent as presented to the board.
Heck, sir.
Any comments? Roll call.
Clough?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle? Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Coughlin?
Yes.
9.8.7.
Yes.
Yes. No, sorry.
Yes. She called you, but I never heard you answer. No, it's the next one.
I apologize. I thought I heard him say yes, and that's why I thought, please stop me.
That's what I thought happened.
Yeah, totally not.
My apologies.
9.8.7, I move that we authorize Dr. Nessing to make employment offers necessary to fill all professional support staff vacancies pending consultation with the Personnel Committee and Board President during the months of June, July, and August to ensure that we fill positions as needed.
Excellent.
Any comments? Roll call.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
Yes.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Clough?
Yes.
9.8.8, I move that we approve the increase in the employment status of Rebecca Scalise from 50% to 62.5%, effective with the start of the 22-23 school year.
Excellent. Any comments?
Just for... this is because we need to have an offer another class of German, so we have so many kids taking her.
Correct.
There's a demand, more of a demand for her need.
Any other comments? Roll call.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Lytle?
No.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Clough?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Moving on to 9.9, technology.
Matt, you want to take care of it?
Sure. Technology, 9.9.1. Make a motion to approve the purchase of staff laptops per the district technology plan at a total cost of $23,001.44. Apple, $9,689, and Dell Computers, $13,312.34.
Thanks.
Any comments? Roll call.
Hetrick.
Yes.
Lytle.
Yes.
Fox.
to approve the iPad community proposal to district families as presented at June 7th work session.
Heck, second.
Any comments? Roll call.
Lionel?
No.
Chris Miller?
Yes.
Heck?
Yes.
Betts?
Yes.
Kaufman?
Yes.
Klaus?
Yes.
Palmer?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Hetrick?
Yes.
Okay. Do we have any new business? Any old business to discuss? Calendar events is listed there. Note that we'll have a special meeting next week to open the bids. And everyone can have off the first Thursday of July. First Tuesday. And
we only do one meeting. Calendar was right. Yeah, just one in July.
Any citizens wish to address the board? Oh, I didn't see it. Go ahead, Tony. Stand up and say your name, please.
Just Anthony wrote it. Just was there an update on the insurance claim as far as that assessment when it came to the stadium?
Yes. We received $4,020.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Anything else?
Look at the motion to adjourn.
So we'll
Heck, second. All in favor, if you would, send the same eye.